So ever since live streaming was invented, it has been a gift and a curse that has taken over the world. We have people live streaming their jobs, we have people live streaming their breaks, live streaming themselves sleeping, live streaming themselves eating, live streaming themselves breaking the law. Most of the time, it's just someone walking around doing nothing but literally just going through their day. And of course, we have the gamers, the shakers, the speedrunners, the ones who are like, you suck, I don't, now watch me f*** it. Whoa! Now, something all of these have in common is that there is always someone who is in charge of the stream, whether that be from behind the camera or you're the director, producer, and actor all in one with the selfie stick.
So it's not cracked, don't worry.
Which is one of the main reasons live streaming is able to work. Take Shia LaBeouf's He Will Not Divide Us stream. There was no one in charge, there wasn't a set person who was going to be there. It was just a public live stream that ended up needing to be streamed from an undisclosed location so that nobody would fuck with it. And even then, they fucked with it. A lesson we all should have learned about live streaming the public. But that was back in 2017, and this is 2024, and people have matured since then. Right? Because we already put the money in for the fucking portal. Please tell me they've matured. But if you haven't heard, they set up these live stream portals in New York and Ireland that allows the people from either side to see a live feed of what's going on. A very cool idea. But I don't think when they announced the location of where these portals were going to be, did they do any research about the city itself. Because no more than 3 days later, did they have to temporarily shut down the portal because of what people were doing on the live stream.
Well, that didn't take long. An art installation in the Flatiron District designed to visually bridge our city with Dublin, Ireland in real time is already causing some trouble. We showed you the portal's debut last week, well after images of people flashing themselves and other bad behaviors, organized realized they had a problem. The Dublin City Council has said in a statement it is looking for ways to come up with a solution to this bad behavior while keeping the portal open so the good intentions behind it can continue.
Now what's funny is when they announced this portal, they were actually thinking that people were going to stand in front of this fucking thing and do TikTok dances. Like Ireland doesn't know what TikTok is. I'd be like, show me a Guinness from the country it's from, I don't know, or like, just because you had people dancing in front of it for the opening doesn't mean people are going to be like, hey, I think this is a dance portal. And you start hitting the renegade hoping some drunk Irish guy does it with you. But like I said, no more than a week later did both sides realize that they can't trust their citizens with shit. And believe it or not, Ireland were the bitches that started it. We didn't start shit. Ireland started it. I don't know if you guys seen the video, but someone's holding up a phone that says RIP or Rest in Peace Pop Smoke. And then right after that, someone holds up a video of the Twin Towers getting fucking hit. And then there isn't a video of this, but someone else holds up their phone to the camera and plays literal porn. And from blackraw.com nonetheless. This is something I would expect from America, but Ireland? Also, this would be an amazing ad for Blacked. Just saying. And then from our side, we're like, oh, you like porn, don't you? Well, have a gander at this. And on two separate occasions, I found two girls flashing the camera. This first one being fucking weird since there's a child literally feet away from her as she does it. And then the second one was apparently the one that got our side shut down, according to her on her Instagram.
So I just got the portal from New York City to Dublin shut down. I thought the people of Dublin deserved to see my two New York homegrown potatoes. And then this happened.
Sorry? Is it down for the night?
Most likely it's going to be off for quite some time because we have, you know, some rules and regulations around. Because it's very unfortunate that people are acting not in the best way, so yeah.
Now, obviously, she wasn't the reason it got shut down, and this dummy just wanted attention because people didn't want to see her asshole as often as they do. So she's like, it's time to be a piece of shit. And I know this because her story is only her posting the articles talking about her. Even posting a picture of autistic Elon being like, inevitable, with the caption, someone tell Elon Musk I have a free trial to my site ready and waiting for him to claim. Bitch, you tag him yourself. And besides, Elon probably doesn't even masturbate. He probably uses fucking photosynthesis to extract the semen, that little freak. And also, your OnlyFans is probably the worst one I've ever seen. No wonder you're offering it for free. You have 14 posts. Save yourself the trouble, guys, and just look at her Instagram. It's the exact same thing. The company portals.org did say, though, that this wasn't because of her and said it was a technical glitch, which I don't believe, but I don't believe it was her, considering what Ireland already showed. Now, I do remember something like this being set up in another country, and about 2 years ago, this same company set up these portals in Lithuania and Poland. Whoever told them New York and Ireland are their country's equivalent did not know what the fuck they were talking about. But New York is one of the top five places you do not want to put these things in. It's right up there with California and Florida. And honestly, I don't think anybody's ready for this, because you can put it in a small remote town, and there's still going to be that one person who takes a shit on camera, ruining it for everyone. And or someone is going to use it to triangle viral for their own gain and ruin it for people that way. Either way, the one thing you can do to try and stop this, or at least slow it down, is by charging people for time in front of the camera. But then I guess that would defeat the whole purpose of putting it up. I can't wait to see what the solution for all this is, because unless you have like a security guard or police right there waiting to arrest anyone who does something wrong, there's no real way of stopping this. They should honestly just put these in the worst neighborhoods we have. That way all the homeless people get distracted and stop bothering us. Until then though, see you guys tomorrow. Peace.